to see this, you missed something, just reach out to us and we'll go ahead and make that link available to you. I am going to take questions at the end of the presentation, so please use the chat function and I'll get to as many of those questions as I can. In the meantime, let's go ahead and get started and we'll introduce you to our newest member of the Ingenious Voice family. And I'll let you know that I'm Doug Hader. I'm the Senior Product Manager for the Ingenious Voice side. And so we're really excited to bring this to you. This webinar today is about the Ingenious Voice Communications and a new product we have called DuraFon Roam. So I first wanted to start and make sure that everyone is aware that we do have an Ingenious Partner Program, and this is something you should be involved with if you're not already involved. It does give you some exclusive benefits and offers. It gives you the ability to use deal registration for that protection. It also gives you the ability to have your rep help you with, you know, product selection. Anytime you're having a customer service issue where you're trying to troubleshoot something, they're there, they're skilled, and you have direct access to them. So definitely look into the Ingenious Partner Program if you haven't already done so. All right. So for those of you who are not aware of us, Ingenious Voice Communications is really known for its range. That's our claim to fame, its range. That's why people seek us out. That's where we're the really strong solution in a lot of very demanding environments. So claim to fame is range. If you don't remember anything else about this, remember that you do have a choice for a long range voice product with Ingenious Voice Solutions. And there are two different brand families. There's the DuraFon side. This is an industrial voice, so this is going to be able to take the bumps and bruises of the more demanding environments like a warehouse or a retail store or something like that, where it is going to be potentially dropped or banged into walls or racking, things like that. And there's also the Freestyle. The Freestyle is more of a carry-away phone. We'll see that more in offices, maybe hotels, things like that, where they typically will have a desk and they'll take the phone with them periodically when they need to go someplace in that environment. Isn't as durable as DuraFon, but does get still crazy range on both sides of the two brand families there. So what is industrial voice? Industrial voice is long range, it's durability, and it's premise mobility so that folks can, you know, be running around doing their job. And it brings both phone and two-way radio communications in a single device. Now, compared to carry away is also long range, but you take it when you need it. So if you were picture that hotel environment, front desk may have one, and periodically they need to take towels to the pool or something like that. Well, they could take the handset with them from the front desk, go to the pool, deliver the towels, come back to the front desk, and, you know, set the phone back in its charger. So it does give them that mobility throughout that environment, but it isn't really meant to be carried with them all day. And it will do phone and two-way radio just like the DuraFon side. So two great sides there, just depends on the need that the customer has. Now, I did mention that our claim to fame is range, so I want to go into that a little bit here and give you a sense of the kind of coverage that we get. And these are kind of typical coverages, not, you know, ideal, things like that. And that's why we'll give you three different environments so you can see what obstacles present to range, and you know, this the same equipment, but with three different environments. So let's take a look at this. I'm going to start at the very bottom here with the freestyle, and the freestyle in a retail store or warehouse, this is kind of a semi-open environment, about 100,000 square feet. If that was the DuraFon, that would be up to 250,000 square feet. And the DuraFon Roam, which is our newest system, can give you about 1 million square feet when fully deployed. Now let's take those same handsets, same bases, and let's look at that in a different environment, the hotel or assisted living, an office building, something like that. So a little bit more obstructed, a lot more floors and rooms, walls, things like that. So if you looked at the freestyle, you'd be getting about 25,000 square feet or approximately 6 floors of penetration. The DuraFon would get you about 50,000 square feet, almost 12 floors of penetration. And the Roam gets you about 200,000 square feet. So a lot more coverage with each of those models. But you can see that's a big difference between just a semi-open environment and then this kind of densely packed environment. Now, if you go to the other extreme, a wide open area, now this may be a picture of a farm or a ranch, something where it's just wide open land, not a lot of trees or buildings, things like that. About 10 acres on the freestyle. So if they did have a barn or something out back, stable, and you just need to cover that, yeah, a freestyle could do that. If it was a more of a working farm, they were out on a tractor and working the fields, figure the DuraFon about 3,000 acres. And that goes for both the DuraFon Roam and the regular DuraFon. So to give you a perspective, 3,000 acres is about 2,200 football fields, American football fields. So massive, massive area of coverage. And to kind of jump back to that retail space here, with the DuraFon and the DuraFon Roam, the 250,000 square feet on the DuraFon is about one and a half Home Depots, just to, again, give you a kind of perspective there. And 1 million square feet in that kind of environment on DuraFon Roam would be like a Boeing aircraft manufacturing plant, just massive amounts of coverage. So when we say our claim to fame is range, this is what we're talking about. Remember, these are not cell phones. These are cordless phones. These are digital two-way radios. And you're getting this kind of crazy coverage in these different environments. And we're happy to talk with you if you have an environment and you want to discuss, hey, what do you guys think? That's why we're here. We're here to support you in coming up with the best solution, the best model for that solution. All right, so where do we fit? So there are several different environments, and you can probably think of some of these. These are going to be large environments where employees need mobility throughout that environment and may or may not be, walls and things like that, or it could be more of an open area. So assisted living is a very popular one with us. If you picture that, these facilities are generally have a unique shape to them, and the staff needs to run around and help the guests or the residents of the facilities. So assisted living and hotels, kind of similar. Hotel motels, all good applications and offices. You might have a security guard sitting at the front area, checking people in, giving directions. Periodically they make rounds, or maybe IT people running around different floors, maintenance staff, things like that. It can also be like a retail store. And this is another one that's over the years, we've had numerous retail stores that use us for their sales staff, their support staff that are helping out customers. So their retail environment's good for us. Restaurants are good for us. Grocery stores, another kind of retail, but a grocery store, also very, very popular. Because you think about it, you know, a lot of people have multiple duties. And so they may be stocking shelves or cleaning shelves at one moment, then called up to work the cash wrap and trying to, you know, manage that and get the most out of your employees by having voice communications. And then, of course, there's warehouses and manufacturing. And, you know, these make a ton of sense where you have that employee running around picking goods, you know, maybe in shipping and then in receiving, you know, vice versa. So lots of different uses. So, you know, the commonality here is that this is a large environment. Employees need mobility, and they need that ability to have voice communications for the productivity, for safety and security. So lots of good things. It's, as I look at this slide, I am drawn over here to the left-hand side, and you'll see that tiger, beautiful tiger. Well, this is a wildlife sanctuary, and I believe her name is Terry, and she runs the sanctuary, and all her staff uses the DuraFon. And you can see it right there. And I was kind of surprised at this image that she has the DuraFon right next to her pistol on her hip there. You know, hopefully they have that so they feel protected if something were to go wrong. But maybe it's, you know, an animal is sick, or they're bringing in a new animal and they're trying to coordinate that. So she does wildcats, but she relies on the DuraFon for all her staff so that they're throughout their acreage, they have communications. So it's a really, really unique opportunity, and just thrilled that they use us. All right, let's start getting into the weeds here a little bit and kind of talking about why do we get such good range. And this is going to apply for the DuraFon Roam as well. All of our voice products are at 900 megahertz. So that's in North America, that's a low frequency for cordless phone use, right? So with cordless phones, you can operate at 900 megahertz. You can operate at a European standard called DAC, which is 1.9 gigahertz. And you can also operate at Wi-Fi 2.4 or 5 gigahertz. So these higher frequencies, and we're kind of on the low side. So why did we choose to operate at 900 megahertz? Well, that low frequency actually goes further. That attenuation is less with a lower frequency. So it allows me to go further, everything else being equal, and I can penetrate better, get around obstacles, and just get better coverage with nothing else different. On top of that, we put out a high output power. So the legal limit for an unlicensed product is 1 watt. So we're putting out just about 1 watt, just slightly less than 1 watt of output power. And that does mean that we have to go through some additional testing. So the FCC has required that we do some additional testing because of that output power. And we have this low frequency. Those two things with antenna sensitivity is really helping us maximize our range, our coverage. Now you start to compare that with some of the other technologies. So let's take a look at DEC. So with DEC, it's 1.9 gigahertz, so it's a higher frequency. So again, it's going to be a little less range. And they generally will put low power with that, and usually around 200 to 300 milliwatts compared to almost 1,000 milliwatts that we put out. And so it means that with DEC, because that frequency, you have to put up various bases and antennas to get coverage. And there's kind of a limit to that. Usually it's 3 or 6 bases or antennas. So that coverage is kind of limited. And it, with that low power and high frequency, the more infrastructure you have to put in. Remember, the range that I was quoting you here of the 100,000 square feet or 200,000 square feet in a warehouse environment, that's on a single base. One base goes up and you get that kind of coverage. So all being equal here, that low frequency and high power is the magic that we have to get the range. So let's compare this a little bit more to Wi-Fi. Now Wi-Fi is 2.4 and 5 gigahertz. And with that, that's the higher frequency, so you're getting less range, and low power, typically 200 to 300 milliwatts, again, compared to just under 1,000 milliwatts. And remember, the other challenge with putting voice on the Wi-Fi is there's so much else already demanding the Wi-Fi bandwidth. So, we have cell phones and laptops and scanners and security cameras. All of these things are using that Wi-Fi bandwidth. Then if you were to add voice to that, then you're, again, really taxing that bandwidth that's available for all this other data that's demanding it. And then comes the challenge of QoS. So you have to decide, QoS, quality of service, who gets priority? Is that the voice or is that the data? If it's voice, then okay, I've got to say here, we're going to give voice anytime that's being used. We'll allow for more bandwidth so that the voice can get through, which is going to slow down everything else, right? And make that more challenging, depending on how many devices you have that are using Wi-Fi. So Wi-Fi, obviously, big demand. You got to have the backbone in there, all the Wi-Fi network, high frequency, low power. So it's not going to go anywhere near as far as we would go at 900, separating that frequency into a nice clean channel like 900 megahertz. All right, we'll touch a little bit before we go into the DuraFon Roam into some of the other products that we do offer. And I wanted to start with the analog versions that have been kind of the mainstay and are still hugely popular before we switch over to the SIP and the Roam equipment. So this is the DuraFon Pro. As some of you may know, these used to come as kits where you'd get a base and a handset. Last year we broke that apart and you can now choose the base. We have a single line base. That's the one on the right hand side, the PSL, which stands for Pro Single Line. And we have a 4-port base, and that's the DuraFon Pro BU. And you can mix and match these up to 8 bases. So if you had 5 ports you wanted to have, you could get a 4-port base and a single port base and do those 5 ports or 5 lines. And then you can choose handsets. So there's a number of handsets to choose from as well, and they'll work with either one of those bases and any number of those up to 8. So you can have up to 90 handsets, and these can be mixed and matched as well. So you have the DuraFon Pro handset. That's, you know, the one that's the most popular, most common, and it's a full feature. So it does telephone and two-way radio at 900 megahertz. And you can, you know, put those on, dedicate them, share lines, whatever you want to do, group them with any of these handsets for that matter. The other one is the DuraFon UHF handset. Now, this is a dual mode handset. And what I mean by that is it does everything that the DuraFon Pro does. So it's 900 megahertz phone, 900 megahertz digital two-way radio broadcast and intercom. But it has a second radio also built in. That second radio is a UHF frequency. A UHF frequency is about 460 megahertz, so it's a low frequency, and it is a licensed frequency. It is what a lot of the two-way radio, business two-way radios use. So, you know, Motorola, Kenwood, Icom, things like that, they'll use an analog UHF frequency, 460 megahertz. So this handset could work with those third-party radios. So if you had a warehouse or a retail store and that you already had deployed a bunch of UHF radios from Motorola, let's say, well, you could have supervisors, managers have one of these dual mode DuraFon UHF handsets, be able to make and receive phone calls, 900 megahertz, and be able to talk and listen to the traffic, the communications on the UHF frequency. So that makes that really, really unique. And again, work with either base. You just get the base, pick the handset. So let's go over to the last handset there, and that's called the DuraWalkie. Now, this handset is very unique for a couple of good reasons. One, it is just a digital two-way radio, so no direct phone access with this one. So those folks that you want to have communications, but you don't want them to have phone access, they could get a DuraWalkie and someone else could be carrying the DuraFon Pro. So the DuraWalkie is a digital two-way radio, allows you to do broadcast, allows you to do intercom, handset to handset, full duplex communications between handsets, works with the Pro, works with the UHF, works at 900 megahertz. The neat thing about the DuraWalkie is that if a full-featured handset, DuraFon Pro, let's say, if a DuraFon Pro handset gets a call and it turns out the information or the customer is better served, you know, that caller is better served by someone who's just carrying a DuraWalkie, the full-featured handset can transfer the call to a DuraWalkie and they can receive the call, help the customer. And when they're done and they hang up, they're again locked out of the system. So I can't think of any other two-way radio that allows you to transfer a call to it. So it makes it really, really unique and very, very, very popular in a lot of these environments, warehouses, retail. One of the big markets for the walkies happens to be oil fields. So they like to have that two-way radio communications. And there isn't a lot of phone calls. So lots of good applications for these various handset and base choices. So these are now separates. You buy a base, any mix match of those. You buy a handset, any mix match of those, and work with the bases. So if you have questions on this, feel free to reach out to your rep and they'll chit-chat you, walk you through that a little bit more. All right, let's look at the DuraFon SIP here real quick. The DuraFon SIP, many of you are familiar with, it is, you know, obviously it's a part of the DuraFon line. It still works digitally, 900 megahertz. So it's still doing that two-way radio, telephone at 900 megahertz. The difference between that Pro system and that PSL system, those are analog-based lines, telephone lines. This is SIP, this is voice over IP, so it's network communications. So this being a SIP system can work behind an IP PBX or a hosted SIP provider. This one can support up to 10 handsets and can give you 4 concurrent phone calls. So where the other one, I could have 8 bases on an analog system, that'd be 32 ports, 32 concurrent calls, all maxed out. This one is really a one base system. It is SIP based, 4 concurrent calls, up to 10 handsets. So they would obviously be sharing those talk paths, if you will. Still is 900 megahertz. So that frequency, that long range, all of that remains the same, but this is the starter, if you will, SIP system on the DuraFon side. And the Roam is gonna take this just to a totally different level, which we'll see here momentarily. So, let's start talking about the Roam here a little bit. So new to us, new meaning it will be available here the first part of May. So product is currently not yet available, but it will be available here the first of May. And the Roam is also long range, but it has the ability to hand off between bases, which makes it completely different from all the other systems we offer. Before, everything was kind of independent bases, and you couldn't be on a call and move to the area of a different base. Even in multi-base systems, you had to reestablish the call. With the DuraFon Roam, you can be on a call, move to a different base area, and maintain that call and seamlessly roam between 8 bases with that call and move anywhere you need to. So it's taken the coverage from, remember, the DuraFon coverage was, let's say, 250,000 square feet in that warehouse retail store environment, to now 1 million square feet in that same environment. So just blown range out of the ballpark by the ability to hand off a call between those bases. So that's the exciting part of the DuraFon Roam, and we'll go into that just a bit more. So I want to come and take you to a screenshot of our webpage introducing the Roam and get you kind of familiar with the different components and, you know, how do I buy this? What do I need to do? So let's take a look at this. Just like I had mentioned on the DuraFon Pro equipment, where you're buying them separately, a base and a handset separately. Same thing here with the Roam. The Roam system has several different components, though. So let me start by the DuraFon Roam BSC. That stands for Base Station Controller. So this is kind of the brains, the management of the system. You have to have a base station controller to deploy this system. So that's your starting point. But one controller, a single controller, can manage up to 8 bases and 90 handsets. So you just need one of them, but you do need a base station controller to make this work. And that gets hooked into your network, and it's gonna manage the handoff of those calls. And if there needs to be updates done, you're gonna pass it through the base station controller to the various downstream components. The base units now look more like access points. And so they can be mounted to the false ceiling, mounted to a wall or regular ceiling, whatever makes sense. And this is meant to, you know, from the old days, we used to take our phone system, and as soon as the word phone system, we'd put it in the phone closet in the corner of a big building, and that was all cement and completely block any antenna signal, right? Well, this is really looks like it belongs out in the main area of a facility, and it can be in a hallway, in assisted living or a hotel, out in the general area of a retail store or warehouse or a manufacturing plant. So it's meant to be in the main area for the best coverage, and you can have up to 8 bases. Now, for those of you that are familiar with our bases, you know that we have rubber duck antennas on all these bases that are removable. They do have a unique thread, so they are left-handed, so you go the opposite direction than you may think. They are never tightened with a wrench. It's always hand tightened, so you don't bust the antenna connector off the board. Same thing with the DuraFon Roam base units. DuraFon Roam base units also have a rubber duck antenna that is removable. Why? If you are familiar with us, you know we have external antennas designed for outdoors and external antennas, but for indoor use, right? The indoor antenna and an outdoor antenna. That coax that attaches to those antennas would take the place of this rubber duck antenna. So you would take this antenna off, attach the coax, the other end of it is on the antenna, and you put the antenna in the best area. And so, yeah, we understand that, you know, if you have outside environment, auto dealership, and you want to take the antenna and put it outside to cover the lot, well, you aren't going to put this access point looking thing outside. So you'd put the outdoor antenna on that and keep this indoors and run that antenna out. So you can have up to 8 base units, 1 base station controller, and up to 90 handsets. A couple of different handsets to choose from. So you have the full featured handset, DuraFon Roam HC, phone calls, broadcast, two-way radio, push to talk, right? And intercom, handset to handset, private, full duplex, talk and listen at the same time, communications between handsets. All that stuff that you're used to with any of our products is built in DuraFon Roam, except now it can go between bases. And we're also, and this is gonna be a little bit later, probably June, the DuraFon Roam walkie. So the walkie is just like the previous walkie for the DuraFon Pro, the analog version. It just does two-way radio. Difference here is that it works with this SIP system. Roam is the SIP system. Works with this, and you can take this system and the walkies, and you can set the base units to allow for broadcast through the bases. You do give up a talk path. So instead of 4 talk paths per base, you're down to 3 talk paths per base. But if you want to do a lot of two-way radio communications, it becomes worth it to give up those talk paths and set some of the bases, all of the bases, to be able to take a broadcast through the base unit, so you're getting the maximum coverage. So again, full featured handset, bases, base station controller, and the walkies are the 4 big components to DuraFon Roam. And this is on our website. Just go check it out, explore a little bit. lots of information from data sheets to users manuals, things like that are all available for you. And for those that haven't been to the product pages, the DuraFon Roam product page is up. It's live. And you can, explore that. So you get into the product pages. And this follows the same format of all of our product pages. So you get a little couple of pictures and a little blurb about it on the system. Same thing with the Roam here. The section I want to point out to you, though, is the resources. So the resources is there kind of in the middle of the page, and it's where you're going to find that data sheet. It's where you're going to find the user's manual, a quick reference guide, a basic setup guide. You'll find some videos on setting things up. You'll also get the RSSI tool instructions. I'll talk about that before we close because it's that important. So all sorts of things that you, want to either share with the customer, learn about, bring in a new hire and train them. It's here and you have these resources readily available to you. Just jump on the product page. The one thing I'll point out on the DuraFon Roam resources is each of those components for the Roam has its own user's manual. So if you're in the handset product page, you're going to find the user's manual for the handset. And if you're on the base station controller product page, you'll find that user's manual on that page. So the base station controller, because it's the core of the system, has the most meaty user's manual. So that's a great starting place. And then little nuances for either the base or the handsets, next one down. So if you really want to get into it, start with the base station controller user's manual. All right. I had mentioned that we can now do the handoff between the bases, and this is a seamless handoff. They don't have to do anything. You don't have to pause. You don't have to wait for it to connect again, all that. If this is installed correctly with this overlap, we'll talk about that with the RSSI, you'll be able to seamlessly roam between any of the bases. And this is going to allow you to take coverage where, we might have had the ability to cover 250,000 square feet in a retail store with the analog version. With the Roam version, now I can cover up to about 1 million square feet just by placing bases in different areas of that facility. So here, this could be an assisted living, it could be a retail store or a manufacturing plant or whatever. But you can see there's several different wings and a main area. Well, I have bases in different areas and I can be a handset and I can walk that whole building and maintain my phone call, right? So either make or receive phone calls no matter where I'm at and where I'm going. So the really, really cool capabilities on DuraFon Roam. So there is a different look, right? For one, you have this base station controller. Again, support up to 8 base units on one controller. Do have to be on the same subnet for this system. So all those bases need to be on the same subnet. Base station controller, base units, 4 talk paths per base, removable antenna, different form factor for those bases, more of like that access point, white in color instead of our gray or black, depending on the model of the other models. And up to 90 handsets, very, very similar form factor on all the DuraFon handsets. You notice a red faceplate on the Roam system, so that would tell you which one it is. Not compatible with the DuraFon Pro or the UHF, so that you cannot mix and match, just if a customer already has a pro and now they want to, you know, move to SIP, get the Roam, they can't use the same handsets that they have. They'd have to upgrade to the Roam handsets. Note, batteries, chargers, handset antennas, those will interchange. So if somebody does have a pro system and they, you know, do they have to throw out all their batteries, all their chargers, things like that? No, they can kind of rob stuff from that and use it with the Roam system. Of course, just like all those other ones, the Roam handsets come with a charger, come with a battery, come with a low profile antenna and a high performance antenna. So they can get up and going. They don't have to, oh, I forgot to order batteries. So frustrating. Comes with everything. So the handsets are good to go, you know, right away. You just need to go through the registration process. We'll talk a little bit about that as well. That base station controller. Base station controller and the bases can be powered PoE. So you can, you know, hook this up behind your PoE switch and power these things up. And the bases come with an AC adapter, but you can choose which one you want to use. There is a micro SD slot to store some information, whether that's configuration or any logs, you know, error logs, or just, you know, logs on, you know, what the activity's been, can be stored right here. The reset button, things like that are on the base station controller as well. The base units, again, I have my choice, AC or PoE. You know, hook it, this is a network, right? So I hook it up with the Ethernet cable. It does also have an RJ11 analog line jack on the base. So if they want that as a backup, or if they're hooking up a call box or something like that, that gets triggered to a base for, you know, somebody at the back door or something, you could do that as well. And rubber duck antenna we've covered. So most of this is very familiar from the previous stuff, just a little different form factor. So with this having this new form factor and the ability to mount the base on the ceiling, how do I place that antenna? Well, let me tell you that that antenna, if it was on the ceiling and the antenna pointed downwards, you're going to get a signal of antenna pattern that extends outward, like you're covering the floor. So if you're covering a large area that is horizontal versus vertical, you'd put the antenna pointing downwards. If it's set flat on a table or something, pointed upwards would give you that same thing. So downwards or upwards, depending on if it's on a ceiling or on a desk, pointed up. And obviously, if you move that antenna to be parallel with the base, then I've changed that antenna pattern. So now I'm going vertical. So if the antenna is now parallel with the base and it is ceiling mounted, my antenna pattern is going to go up and down. So it'll go up a floor, down a floor, that kind of stuff. So keep that in mind on the positioning of that rubber duck antenna. Same thing on the walls, right? So if I mounted this on the wall, let me see if I've, if I had this on a wall, well, if I have that wanting to go down a hallway, I would have it parallel to the base because now it's going this way because now I have it on the side. So get familiar, think about it, because this is going to make a difference in getting that optimal coverage. Is that antenna position? And it is, it's an elbow antenna. It's movable, so it can be down or up or side. So lots of flexibility there. And just think about the antenna pattern. And again, talk to your nGenius rep if you have questions on the best way to get that coverage that you're looking for. Okay, so really what gets hooked up, right? Okay, so I've got my PoE switch because we wanted to run this off PoE. I run the network cable to the base station controller, so it's part of the network, and I run it to the base units, up to 8 base units, and they will find each other, and the base station controller will start to manage those bases. I can add a POTS line or a PSTN line to the bases if I want to, really fail safe, or that call box scenario is probably where you'd end up using the twisted pair, right? So that POTS line. All right, so one of the other big differences with DuraFon Roam versus all of our other products is the ability to remotely manage, monitor, and update this system. And you can do that via the nGenius Cloud. It allows you to link to, from the cloud, link to the base station controller of what you want to manage. So there's new GUI involved, not too dissimilar from the DuraFon SIP GUI, if you're familiar with that, but a little bit different in that now we go to the nGenius Cloud to manage it. And so you'd get into the nGenius Cloud, you'd go to the base station controller, connect to that, and then you're going to get a dashboard like this. And so I want to just spend a couple of seconds getting you familiar with the dashboard. So initially on the far left-hand side there, you'll see a bunch of icons, navigation icons. And this is where you can go from the dashboard into the bases, the handsets, topology view, all sorts of choices on the far left-hand side. And you can pull the user's manual and, you know, run through, you know, hey, what does each one of these offer me? And we'll continue to kick out some videos to and some documents to walk you through this, get you real familiar with it. It shows you all the bases that you have. So in this scenario, I have 7 bases and they're either connected to VoIP or they're connected to an FXO, an analog line. And it can tell me whether it's in use or not, you know, all that kind of stuff. So a quick look of what's going on the left-hand side there. And I can look at that right-hand side and see the base station controller. I can see that there's 7 bases, they're all online. I can see the handsets, and so it shows that we have 3 handsets, 2 of them are free, 1 of them is busy. It's already making a call, even show you if a handset's ringing or if it's unavailable. So lots of information just from the dashboard and more detailed information as you go down those lines. How much? So the base station controller has an MSRP of just under $300. Remember, you only need one, and will manage up to 8 bases and 90 handsets. The handsets remain at $399. So just under $400 gets you the handset, the battery, the charger, all to work with the system and a couple of handset antennas, high performance, low profile. And the base units, also the same price as our other bases at $1,199.99, so just under $1,200 for a base unit. Comes with the rubber duck antenna, and it's all set to go part of this system. And it does come with an AC adapter. But as you know, you can hook it up to PoE. Accessory-wise, what's the same that we you might be familiar with the DuraFon Pro. So if you had one of our headsets, those are the same. You don't have to get a special one for this. There is Bluetooth available in DuraFon Roam, not available in the others, but you can still have a wired headset. We do have the hook style over the ear, or the security style, I'll call it, you know, the in-the-ear plastic tube style. Those are still available and work with either the Pro or the Roam. The chargers, same charger, so you can plug that in and just set the handset in that, charge batteries, belt clips, comes with the belt clip, and same belt clip as you may be familiar with when the most of the DuraFon product. Batteries, same, so you still get the batteries, still do, can do battery hot swap, so if you needed to put a call on hold and change the battery, you can do that, change a shift, whatever, and put in another battery. And if they did have an older, you know, DuraFon Pro system, yeah, you can use those same batteries. And the cases are the same. So all of those kind of things, and obviously you know about the outdoor antennas and indoor antennas, all the same. So try to keep the accessories and things you may already be familiar with the same as what we've had in the past. If you aren't familiar with our indoor antenna and our outdoor antenna and our splitter, things like that, these are them. So that bell-shaped item in the coax there, that's the indoor antenna. It comes with about 66 feet, 20 meters of low loss coaxial cable with those unique adapters. Remember I said that the rubber duck antenna has a unique left-handed thread TNC adapter on the base. The coax that comes with this antenna already has that adapter on there, and so you don't have to worry about finding it or attaching it or any of that. Comes with it. The antennas also have a unique adapter. They're reverse thread N style. Coax has both sides already attached. Remove the rubber duck antenna, put on the coax for whatever antenna. The far left-hand side is the outdoor antenna. So I think we talked about a auto dealership. Yeah, that would be the antenna for that. The thing at the bottom there is a splitter. It allows you to attach two antennas. So I attach the splitter to the base and I can attach two indoor antennas to go down a hall, up a hall, up a floor, down a floor, however I want to do it. Or I can have an outdoor antenna and an indoor antenna, two outdoor antennas, whatever I want to mix and match there. But it does split the signal 50-50 from the base to these antennas. And obviously you have eight bases, you can do a lot of crazy stuff to get the coverage that you need, and especially in just certain areas. I just need one base to have an outdoor antenna. Okay, no big deal. Remove that, attach the outdoor antenna. Lightning protection kits available for it, couplers are available. So all the other antenna stuff, if you need to find out more, ask your rep or visit our website and go through the different accessories. Then finally, again, encourage you, especially with DuraFon Roam, there are some wonderful value by joining the partner program. Number one, having access to our internal reps, direct call. You got an issue, you got a question, you can call directly into our reps and talk to them, and they are there to serve you. And they can pull technical people, they can pull, you know, product managers, whatever you need. They're your number one resource. but it gives you some benefits from your channel partner, your distributor. It gives you the ability to register deals with us that protects you, gives you a little bit of an advantage. Definitely, if you're not a Ingenious partner, join up. If you think you're a partner, but it's been a while, things have changed a bit. Call the rep. They'll walk you through this process and tell you what you know, what's available to you and what it takes to qualify, things like that. So take a look at that. So I wanted to thank you again. I really, really appreciate that. I know we went through a lot of information in a relatively short period of time. I have, it looks like about 5 minutes left. Happy to take some questions. So if you have any questions, please feel free to put them in the chat environment there. And let me see if I can answer some of these before time runs out. So let me kind of scroll down through some of these here. How many phones can be in the same system in the same area? So from the top level, I can have 90 handsets as part of the system. Each base unit can support 4 concurrent calls, right? I can have lots of handsets doing two-way radio if it's not going through the base, but I can have 4 concurrent calls per base. So if I'm in a denser area where maybe I need, you know, 12 concurrent calls, I'd have 3 bases roughly about 15 feet apart on the minimum side, right? That would serve that area because of phone traffic. And then I can start to really spread them out to get coverage. So I hope that answered that question. Do you still need to register handsets? Changed just a little bit in that the registration is done partly in the GUI, and where you add a handset, and partly on the handset, just like before, where I go into the registration mode of menu 6.1 kind of thing. But I'm triggering it from the GUI as well to get the system to link. The Roam bases, water, dust proof. Is there an option for, I'll say, an outdoor environment or a wet environment, something like that? The housing for that is not meant to be outside and getting exposed to all that. It is really an indoor kind of environment. If you were to have something where you're exposing it to moisture, things like that, you may want to consider a housing around it, but with the rubber duck antenna exposed, so like a NEMA case, something like that, where you can protect that base bit, have the antenna exposed to get the signal, but you're keeping the base from, you know, whatever the water moisture is that you have going around in that environment. The headsets, I think we talked about a little bit. You can get wired, you can get Bluetooth for the headsets. Both are available. Bluetooth, we don't really sell any Bluetooth headsets, but obviously there's a gazillion. We do sell those 2 different styles of wired headsets. Remote monitoring and configuration portal available. As you remember, we went through the dashboard. That goes into a lot of stuff. So you can look at, I meant to talk about the RSSI. RSSI allows you to know where to put the bases. So the RSSI signal can still be managed, looked at, viewed from the GUI, and you can tell, hey, is this a good area for a base? Next area, you know, compared to where the handset is. And about a minus 75, again, talk to your rep when you're starting to look at this, And they'll tell you exactly, okay, yeah, this is the DBM that you need to for the secondary base. But yeah, that information is in the GUI. Check out the product pages. The base station controller's user's manual goes through a lot of the detail. The quick reference and quick setup guides go into a little bit of detail there too. And we will be posting even more videos and things if you want to watch how this is done and set up, but you can get a good sense. Yeah, that orientation we did talk about on the bases. So if you have questions on how do I put that base rubber duck antenna, call the reps. They understand, that antenna pattern. They'll walk you through that. There is an FXO port in that you're going to want to hook your phone line, right, to that. And now, as I just to confuse you, is if you have a call box or something like that, that could get plugged into it. It's really FXO back to the office, so phone line into the base. The controllers are the controllers set to search for services from the NGS cloud by default? I'm not 100% sure what they're getting at there, but the NGS cloud, if you're familiar with the NGS Sky Key, this kind of works the same way in that the NGS cloud gives you this link to the base station controller. So you go onto the NGS cloud, you'll find a little icon, a little phone that would allow you to link to the base station controller, and you connect to that, and then you can get at all the things that the system does for that, starting at that base station controller. Let's go down here. The Bluetooth is 5.1, I think. I don't think it's 5.2, but I'll have to check on that. I'll let you know on that. The MSRP question on that. Yeah, these are really similarly priced to the DuraFon Pro system, frankly. The only additional component to this is the base station controller, and that's $300, and it controls 8 bases. So, lots of value here compared to anything else out there, frankly, given the amount of infrastructure needed to achieve what we're able to achieve. There are lightning protection kits available. The bases still can cover 250,000 square feet individually, right? But you do need overlap. That's why when I say 8 bases, a million square feet, that's what I'm talking about. Let's see. The watt on the POE. Basically any of the POE switches would be able to power this. It takes very little. I'll have to look up exactly what the base station controller requires and the base units. So I'll kind of copy everybody on an email just to let you guys know on those two different components that can get plugged into POE so that you have that handy. And I think I ran through most of those, and I know I ran over a little bit. I appreciate everyone who did stay on. I really appreciate that. And I'm excited to have you guys give us some feedback on DuraFon Roam. It's a tremendous. We've been playing with it here for a couple of months now in the beta. I've handed out to a couple of beta folks, and they've loved them in really demanding environments. So we're really excited. I think you will be too. So if you have those large environments, this is the solution. So thank you guys all. I really appreciate it. Everyone have a wonderful day. Take care now.